Hello everyone, Dr. Ross here, and as promised, I wanted to make a quick video and show you how I do my post-production when I take my intraoral series photos that we practice together during the hands-on portion of the class. First thing you need to do is, of course, locating all your files. Here's a series of photos we took together. As you can see, they are all raw because they are NEF. Whether you shoot RAW or JPEG, first thing you need to do is to locate your files. I select all the photos I want to edit and I right click and open with my program of choice. You can do this with most programs like Photoshop, Lightroom, and other PC picture processing programs. Adobe Lightroom happens to be my favorite because they just make it very simple and straightforward. This, by the way, is very similar for both PC and Mac. What you see should be exactly what you would also see in this program if you're using a PC. Here I'm using a Mac. This first page shows you a preview of all the pictures you're planning to edit. If you see anything that you don't like, you can just unclick. I usually only keep what I need to edit on my camera, and if I have a photo that I don't want to keep, I just delete on my camera before I put everything on the computer. So this looks good to me, a regular intraoral series for a patient of ours. I add all photos to our editing queue, and now this takes me to our editing page. So here at the bottom left corner, we see different ways to view all images. When I like to edit, I go into the D, which means I see one picture at a time. At the bottom, we also have the option of seeing all the images that we're planning to edit. If you don't like to see that, you can simply hide that by this shortcut on the lower right. I like to see what I'm editing. You can reverse the order of your photos so it shows you from the very first photo you take all the way to the end. As I told you during the course, I take all the photos with the same exact order. It just makes it a lot easier for you and your staff. So once you're in the editing view, on the right side of the screen, you see the editing options. Most of what we need to do for a quick post editing are the first two options, the edit panel that gives you things like exposure, contrast, highlight, and much more that you don't normally need to use, and also our crop menu that allows us to mirror our photos, flip them, or straighten them. So let's get to it. As we spoke before, the first image is always the upper right quadrant. You have to realize that every time you take a photo using a mirror, you will always have a reversed image of reality. So the first thing I do, I go to the crop menu and I use the mirror image. So when I press that, it mirrors it horizontally. And now this is a much more realistic presentation of what I captured. On the upper right photo, if I want to now rotate this, I can use the flip, and now it feels that I'm looking at the upper right. Once you're in the crop menu, you can see on the sides, you can select the portion of the picture that you're interested in. This is exactly why we said it's better to capture more than less, because you can always crop later and choose exactly the portion of teeth that you need. Usually for the first photo, I'm interested in the upper right molars and premolars. Once I have the window I like, I press enter on the keyboard and there I have it. I move on to the second photo, going from the upper right to the upper anteriors. Like we taught you in the course, I like to take an incisal view and a lingual view. Again, for both of these, we used a mirror. So the first thing I need to do is to go to the crop menu and do a horizontal flip. Now, what I see on the right side is the right of the mouth, and what I see on the left side is the left of the mouth. So this is the right of the patient and the left of the patient. Once I have flipped I select the portion of the image that I'm interested in. We have the premolars on the posterior shots, so I don't need to worry about that. And if you want to straighten the image or rotate, you can just put your mouse on the any of the corners, and by going left and right on your touchpad, you can straighten the image the way you like. I like this. I press enter. This is all I need. If you feel like this is a little bit washed out or overexposed, you can go back to the first editing menu on the right and play with the exposure. If you go to the right, it increases exposure. If I go to the left, it decreases your exposure. I'm pretty happy with this image. I go to the lingual shot again. I use the mirror for this photo, so I do a horizontal flip. Now I have a realistic view of what I captured. I select the frame that I'm interested in. I press enter. I like what I see. Maybe I reduce the exposure a little bit. And I'm happy. Moving on to the next one now. I'm looking at the upper left. Just like all the other photos, we use the mirror, so we have to flip. And then I rotate until I like what I see. I like this rotation. You can do vertical or horizontal. For most of my presentation, I prefer wider images. So this is how I edit my upper left quadrant. I like what I see. I press enter. If you have little dots or by any means you'd like to clean up your photo and you have a hair, you can always use what we call the healing brush here. That's the third from the top. It gives you a little circle. You can increase or decrease the size of your circle, and it has the ability of understanding and recognizing what you'd like to remove. If I click on that little dot that's bothering me, it will automatically sample from its environment and clean all these little dots that you may see on your photo. Once you're happy, you press enter, and there, your picture is clean. Very quick, easy tool to clean your photos. Moving on to the next, now I'm looking at the lower left. It's a mirrored image. I do a horizontal flip, and I rotate until I'm happy with what I'm looking at. We could have done so much better here. Another trick to avoid all these bubbles was to blow air before you shoot, or simply use your suction. I like what I see here. Decrease my exposure a little bit if I need to clean any dusts that are on my sensor. I use the healing brush, press enter, and now we're good to go. Now we're looking at the lower anterior shots, incisal shot and lingual shot. Do it a little bit quicker here. I do a horizontal flip. I can bottom grab the corner. I like what I see here. I press enter. We're good to go. Now I take my lingual shot. Do a horizontal flip. I select the portion of the image that I'm interested in. This is a bit dark. I go to my editing menu, and I increase exposure just slightly. Now I'm on my last quadrant, which is the lower right quadrant. Go to the crop menu, flip horizontally. I like this view. It makes me feel like I'm sitting on the upper right quadrant and just looking down at the lower right quadrant. Again, we could have suctioned or blow some air to avoid these bubbles. But the point of this video really is post-production. If I get to a photo that I don't need, I probably retook this photo with less bubbles. Let's say we don't need it, we can just right click and delete photo. Same, right click, delete photo. So this is now all our quadrant photos. Of course, right after we take a frontal view photo. I like this one better because I asked the patient to bring their tongue back. So I right click, delete this one. So In this photo now, I haven't used a mirror, so we don't need to flip horizontally. You've captured what you see. I just do a regular flip so I can see the picture horizontally. Again, we did not use a mirror, so we don't need to use the mirror option. I just grab the corners of the picture and I straighten it to my liking. I like to use these guidelines in the middle to make sure that I am as parallel as possible to the incisal edges of the two front teeth. Press enter. It's good to go. Again, if you need to clean anything, use the healing brush as you wish. Don't overuse it. Just use to clean little dents or if you have any dust on your sensor. Here we have another one. Just flip it, select a portion I'm interested in, straighten, and I press enter. This is a side view. I didn't use a mirror here, so I took it straight exactly how it is. All I need to do is to rotate and select what I like. Side view again without a mirror, so I just do a flip, I select, press enter, good to go. Now for these side views, this is the most difficult photo that we took in the intraoral series. It's a little bit tricky on how to place the mirror. Really like these photos, tells us a lot. Again, because I use the mirror, the first thing I need to do is to do a horizontal mirroring or a horizontal flip. Now I know I'm looking at the left side of the patient. Once I have the image flipped, then I select the portion I'm interested in. Try to hide your mirror as much as possible in post-production. Press enter. I love what I see. Now this is the right side of the patient. Again, I flip it since this was taken through a mirror. The picture could be a lot better, but again, we were practicing and demoing, just trying to show you how to do your post-production here. If I like what I see, press enter. There we are. Took some photos from the anterior teeth with the black background. I look at everything, pick my favorite. If I don't like these two, I can select both of them, right click and delete. Try to keep only what you need so you don't have to go through too many pictures later on. I didn't use a mirror here, so I just cut my frame to what I like. Let's make it a really cool white photograph. I like what I see now. If you want to play with exposure here to get a little bit brighter, you can do that here. I don't recommend really going and playing a lot with texture clarity unless you're trying to create something that is for a cool post or an art production. These images, again, is only for our presentation purposes and for talking to our patient. Full arch photos, very similar to what we've done so far. Do horizontal flip. Now we're looking at the true representation of the photo because it's taken through a mirror, of course. Select it to my liking. Press enter. I feel like it's a little bit too exposed for me, so I turn down the exposure. If you want to cut a little bit more, you can go back anytime to the crop menu and just crop a little bit more. There we are. Last but not least, lower arch full photo. Again, I use a mirror here. I do a horizontal flip and I rotate. I like to look at the lower arch and edit it in a way where I feel like I'm directly looking at it. It's a lot easier for patients to understand this is the lower arch when you rotate it with the anterior at the bottom. Like what I see here, press enter. If I didn't like how much I cut here, I go to the crop menu again and I just choose a little bit more. There we are. This is all our images edited. They're clean, ready to be used for a presentation. Once you have everything that you like and you've edited and it's all clean to you, you can select all of them. You can select the first one, hold shift, select the last one. And then on the upper right corner, you see this export button. There's many different ways you can export. I like to use 100% quality. Now I can export in JPEG. I've had the chance to see and maximize the quality use of all my images because these were all taken in RAW. Now I'm exporting in JPEG because this is a lot easier to use in presentations and handle. Once you press that, then it asks you where you would like to save your photos. If you're already connected to your server, you can go to that patient's folder, create a folder for the day you took all these photos, and click export. And there you'll have the nice edited JPEG format of all the pictures that you just edited. I hope you find this video helpful. If you had any questions, feel free to reach out to us with email, reach out to me on Instagram. I'd be happy to answer your questions. Have a great day.